Chief Minister welcomed Sri Sri Ravi Shankar to take part in peace talks if insurgent groups come forward for dialogue with the government. Locals of Wangai Hijam Lairak boycott Wangai Panthau and his followers over land issue. Imale Sem Inat Loiseng denies allegation. And All Manipur Entrepreneurs Association identifies new business opportunities between India and Myanmar during 12-day tour to neighbouring country. Hello and welcome to Impact News. You're watching Primetime English News. I'm Tanshwam Sangeeta with top stories and latest news at this hour. Chief Minister Okram Ibobisingh today welcomed Sri Sri Ravi Shankar to take part in talks if insurgent groups come for peace talks with the government. He said this after the Art of Living Foundation founder Sri Sri Ravi Shankar said he is willing to take part in peace talks if insurgent groups come forward for dialogue with the government. He was speaking during the function of an evening of music and meditation held at Bhagyachandra Open Air Theatre. Chief Minister further said he invites all the insurgent groups belonging to Hills and the Valley for talks. He also said there is a solution for every problem. Attending the function were Deputy Chief Minister Guy Khangam, Speaker T.H. Lokeshwar, former Chief Minister Radha Vinod Koijam, top civil and police officials, along with more than 500 people in attendance.
And I will try from my side to invite them for talk. I once again thanks Guruji and also for the entire people of Manipur for your kind visit here in Manipur to help us and also for the future of the people of Manipur. Guruji will definitely advise and appeal whatever you can from your end.
Earlier, the founder of the Art of Living Foundation, Sri Sri Ravi Shankar, said if all the communities of the state come together, leaving their differences behind, the state will head towards a better and prosperous state. In an exclusive interview with Impact News, Sri Sri Ravi Shankar further added, it's about time all the institutions trying to build a society with the help of guns and violence drop their weapons and try to obtain their goals in a peaceful manner. Such unrest and chaos in the society holds back the state from progress, and there's no place in the world where guns have brought progress. He also appealed to people to take part in the different courses of the Art of Living Foundation in order to maintain peace of mind.
Deep inside, everybody has a good heart. Mm-hmm. I would say even all these militants, mm-hmm. boys, they are not bad people. They have passion in their heart to do something big. Mm-hmm. They are committed for a cause. And their cause is to bring prosperity. My only request to them is, please understand, just by gun, nobody has brought prosperity to any place. Mm-hmm. You come with the conviction of non-violence and hold on to the cause of social justice. With the principle of non-violence, with the cause of social justice, if we all come together, we can achieve wonders. Mm-hmm. Because they have a sense of sacrifice. Today we don't see that sense of sacrifice in many people. Mm-hmm. So with these youths, we have a great hope to build this entire region. So I request them, you come with an open mind, let us sit and dialogue. Let us see how your goals can be realized.
Locals of Wangai Hijam Lairak have boycotted Wangai Panthau and stopped his followers from entering Panthau Isai Kono. The decision was taken by the locals during a public meet held today in the morning. Locals of Wangai Hijam Lairak have alleged that Panthau has encroached land in the locality. Last night, locals of Wangai Hijam Lairak, Imphal East, vandalized properties at Panthau Isai Konung, alleging that the Maira Pai Bisang has been encroached by Wangai Panthau. At around 8:30 p.m. last night, large number of locals stormed the Panthau Isai Konung. The matter escalated after Panthau's elder brother, Hijam Sarat, allegedly assaulted W. Narasingh and W. Purnimasi. Three cars and other properties were also damaged. Police personnel led by Imphal East Additional SP Manjeet rushed to the spot and controlled the situation. Speaking to media after the public meet, Hijam Ledak Mairapai B. Lyceum Loop Secretary Thongam Chitra said Panthao is challenging the locals by trying to encroach the land of Mairapai B. Lyceum Loop office. She also said locals have boycotted Wanghai Panthao until he apologizes to the locality. During the public meet, a resolution was also taken to stop devotees of Panthao from entering the Panthao Isai Konung until the matter is resolved. Meanwhile, Imphal Lyceum Inat Loiseng today denied all allegations raised by the locals of Wanghai Hijam Ledak. Meeting media persons at an undisclosed location, Imphal Lyceum Inat Loiseng Secretary Ahiba Medha said destroying properties belonging to Panthao is unfortunate. She said Panthao and his followers have never initiated any fight or argument with the locals. Medha said 3 years back, Imphal Lyceum Inat Loiseng bought the land in the locality belonging to Haubam Ibopisak. She said a proposal was given to Mairapai Bis for construction of Loiseng office and a Mairasang next to the property. She said no instructions were given to dismantle the Mairasang. Medha said at around 10 a.m. in the morning, club members gave them a notice asking them to remove the temporary fencing of the property. However, some locals resorted to vandalizing properties in the evening.
Makoi hijen ba oigani akoi isam na madudi tauhiba laite kai guna da akoi di lining zaba lakoni laiphongi miyama na miyama khu thaba ba sudi isa sing na su thabirong gani ha ba se thaja biganu leba ki bubiri ba ima maira pai bi ima sing dai palem sakpa panthau sakpi puna mangna ima laise mina loi sangbu tengwang biu akoi di lining loi ne akoi laipham jangba phangdre laipham jangba phangdre panthau laise akoi na laiwai ba ne na ningjeri ba sibu la le ha ba sibu leibak miyam na wayen biro akoi ma se haiba ngamdre.
The Lining Thau Sana Mahi Thawal Kanglop has appealed to all the branch offices, members of the Kanglop and all the people to participate in the 22nd May mass rally organized by the Scheduled Tribe Demand Committee in the demand to include Meitei Meitei in the Scheduled Tribe list. All Manipur Entrepreneurs Association concluded 12-day Myanmar trip, which aimed at identifying new business opportunities between India and Myanmar. The trip was sponsored by Manipur Government, Department of Commerce and Industries. 10-member team undertook the trip from 22nd of March till the 2nd of April and visited Tamu, Monewa, Mandalay, Yangon, Naypyidaw, Lasio and Muse. The 10-member team also met a team of Mandalay Regional Chamber of Commerce on the 30th of March. The team identified Mandalay as an important commercial hub as Thailand and China are easily accessible. The team of All Manipur Entrepreneurs Association met media persons yesterday at Nauwa Restaurant located at Rims Road. Association President Sawaijam Rishi Kumar hoped that state's economy will increase in case agro-food products and horticulture products of Myanmar are made available in Manipur. Rishi Kumar said, Myanmar lacks in health sector and if Manipur can provide international standard health services, then the people from Myanmar and Southeast Asian countries will flock the state, increasing the economy of the state.
Horticulture, agriculture product Myanmar da fangi se. Marang kai se fangi, maman juhong ebe India fangi beri achi regi. Mango juice puto ehen khal lor se ba. This kind of fruit chingchi Myanmar da jam hong fangi ba. Mo ara ara pa Mumbai degi, Delhi degi, long distance se chie leba si kano singe. Just a few kilometer distance se fangam ni na. Akoi na adu lower kanda juice man, the sector kan da yam ne hena competitive way mong da koina pote puto pung ngam ngani health care is one of the area ni moi rong gi health care si yam na advance way bo oidri adu ga moi na india rom da langning da bagi yam khangna india ga man mar connectivity si yam na hande ba india da lakho dire pesham sat pani na thailand rom da adi singapore rom da sat pani na moi oje ne low way ba akoi more connectivity or leira ba akoi gi visa office ma tamu da hanga ba adu ga di definitely man mar gi kamu si akoi gi manipur gi leira ba health care sector si na
All Manipur Entrepreneurs Association President Sawaijam Rishikumar said there are a few issues like road transport problem, language barrier, and issue of visa. He said all these problems need to be tackled soon as center has implemented the Act East policy. He said if center and the state government increases the number of flights between India and Mandalay, then it will boost the business sector. People associated with business can benefit if visa on arrival facility is provided to them. Rishi Kumar added, Manipur needs to construct good quality bridges and roads so that big machineries are imported from Mandalay, which have been built by China, Taiwan, Korea and Thailand. Rishi Kumar informed media persons that All Manipur Entrepreneurs Association, in association with Ministry of External Affairs, will organize a business exhibition at Mandalay in September or October this year. Sawajam Rishi Kumar said the association will soon submit their experience and steps which India and Manipur can improve to boost the economy.
Akuina business the moiga deal to work katang khutong jadawam na language it is one of the another key issue ne ba mo english ki education ji moita seng na yam lap kre ba pa phono no khona ba dawa mo ba spoken english ku mata pi ba gi education ji jo akui Manipur gi kambu sina dum sanghel lakanda class khra lo mutum dai thoina kana ga shoin kana ne ankal All Manipur Entrepreneurs Association, Manipur Labour Manufacturers, Entrepreneurs, I am Sikuna, invite to Rakanda exhibition, Yahongani, organization, sing, subsector labor, business to be Miami, my magi activities, may I do, highway exhibitions, Utlagani, Makurum the Ladyba, Aquidigi, Pambasing Dusu, no Ninigi exhibitions of Moina Pangani, Moiga tied up to Rakana business to Aquay. Paksha na tawunga magani makhoi demand akoi khangani akoi supply tawani adi akoi need and requirement shu makhoi dege amuk lorgani amain troga koi business jathagani
Joint Committee of Inner Line Permit System JCILPS today organized a public meeting of club organization Mairapai Bilup and students organization at Langjing Achoba Community Hall on implementation of ILPS in the state. Speaking on the occasion, convener JCILPS Khomdram Ratan condemned the failure to take up any further step by the state government to enact the three bills passed by the assembly on 3rd August into act. MLAs and ministers unable to press the center regarding the bills clearly show that they are not interested in the welfare of the state. Ratan added that it is now time to teach the authority a lesson with a mass uprising and urge the people to get ready for intense agitation. 9 resolutions including urging the government to convert the bills into act, Constitution of Land Reform Commission and Manipur Population Commission and non-cooperation to non-Manipuri were adopted at the meeting. United NGOs Mission Manipur has appealed to the President of India, Pranab Mukherjee, to repeal Armed Forces Special Powers Act 1958 from Northeast India and to meet the victim families of extrajudicial execution by the Indian Army, paramilitary and state police force during his visit on 23rd of April. Addressing media persons today at Manipur Press Club, convener of Women Committee, United NGOs Mission Manipur, Sobita Mangsatabam said after President's last visit in 2013, series of human rights violations under Armed Forces Special Powers Act has been happening in the entire Northeast India. Sobita said they are going to send a memorandum to the President to repeal Armed Forces Special Powers Act along with reports of violation of human rights. She added that 5 unidentified dead bodies were recovered from various places of Manipur throughout the year 2015. She said 5 persons were brutally tortured and killed by certain insurgent group who are closely associated with the Indian Armed Forces. 4 civilians were killed by unidentified persons. All the victims and their family members were denied justice by the government. The Imphal West District Magistrate in a press release informs that curfew imposed in Wangoi subdivision was relaxed today from 1 p.m. to 5 p.m. Curfew will also be relaxed tomorrow from 5 a.m. to 5 p.m. It may be recalled that the curfew was imposed by the Imphal West District Magistrate after the Mayang Imphal incident on 11th of April. The gathering of more than five people, possession of objects like stone, knife or sticks that could be used as weapon is still restricted under the CRPC Section 144 in this subdivision. First All Manipur Mushroom Growers Meet 2016 was held today at Manipur Press Club. The meet was jointly organized by Temperate Mushroom Center and Integrated Mushroom Association under the sponsorship of KVK Imphal West. The meet aims to form a producer company for the mushroom growers of the state. The meet was attended by officials of ICAR, KVK Imphal West, NABARD and mushroom growers across the state. Speaking to media persons, Secretary of MS Integrated Mushroom Association, SH Ibohal Sharma said, all the mushroom growers of the state need to unite together so that they can register under Company Act to ease the difficulties faced by the mushroom growers of the state. Panthoibi Sindham Sanglin Chingfu Kaithel organized the second Maichau Ningching Thoram at Chingfu Kaithel located at Waheng Khumman in Bishnupur district. A souvenir was also published as part of the event. Speaking at the event, T.H. Premjit, a member of the Sanglin, said the first Remembrance Day was held in the year 1984 in memory of the Maichaus. Many resource persons also spoke at the event. Living Arts Academy, Manipuri Thangta Sagolban Tera observed the 33rd Foundation Day at Anti-Theatre Playhouse Hongmeng Sang located at Changangai Uchekon Airport, Lai Maning. Prayers were offered to Ibudo and rich floral tributes were paid to the portraits of the late senior teachers of the academy. The students of the academy displayed different moves of Thangta at an event. Gifts were also distributed to visiting gurus and students of the academy. In a press release, Manipur State Power Distribution Company Limited, MSPDCL, informs to consumers of Singjamai, Kongwa and Wanghai subdivision that prepaid metering is in progress by empaneled contractors in different localities. The workers of the contractors are provided with identification cards to avoid misuse of consumer documents and over-collection of money from consumer other than the requisite 200 rupees for first-time recharge. Any misappropriation found in the field may kindly report to the undersigned with identification details of the person involved. In another press release, MSPDCL informs that there will be no power supply in the area supplied by Singjamai and Kanchipur feeder tomorrow from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. due to installation of two new 25 kVA DTRs in Singjamai, Mayang Lekai and Kawa Pechu Lampa for the street lighting purpose. It's time for a small commercial break. We'll be back in a short while. Keep watching Impact News.
Kuira bagi tungda punbasi noy.
Sumi, madikari tore.
Ma kese double strength nising pumali.
Mangonde PU double strength liver tonic.
Lipsap DS.
Lipsap DS double strength liver tonic.
Welcome back. You're watching Primetime English News. A national workshop on the theme Skilling India to Build India was organized at Singjamai Hairangoi Thong Multipurpose Community Hall today. Speaking at the occasion, the chairman of the Federation of Skill Development Organization, Anil Holsa Mudrakar, said the workshop will enable literate and illiterate youths in making themselves self-employed. Regional coordinator of the workshop, Dr. Mainam Bimota, said almost 20 lakh youth of the country will be trained in several disciplines till 2020 under the Skill India mission, which will commence from July. The youth who successfully completes the program will be provided with work opportunities in India, Myanmar, Thailand and Malaysia.
अभी आवश्यकता है स्किल डेवलपमेंट के माध्यम से मेक इन इंडिया का नारा गुंजायमान करने के लिए क्यों करना है ये सब एक महान भारत की रचना एक समृद्धशाली भारत की रचना एक अजय भारत की रचना जिसमें भय नहीं होगा भूख नहीं होगी भ्रष्टाचार नहीं होगा इस प्रकार के राष्ट्र का निर्माण करने के लिए आप कटिबद्ध हो इस प्रकार की प्रार्थना करने के लिए मैं आपके सामने गया
12 Assam Rifles of 26 Sector Assam Rifles under the aegis of Headquarter IGAR South organized an interaction program with the Women's Society of Technopal Village in Chandan District yesterday. Various women empowerment related welfare schemes were highlighted during the interaction. The program also emphasized on safety of women and various laws enacted by the government for women's safety. Troops of 29 Assam Rifles of 28 Sector Assam Rifles under the aegis of Headquarter IGAR South arrested three MNRF cadres at Aimol Zopi village in Chandal district on 16th and 17th of April. The arrested persons are identified as self-styled Sergeant Major Athoy, also known as Wang Shumi, age 26, son of Harumi Hunyo of Lehauram Ukrul, self-styled Sergeant Waisingam, age 30, son of David, resident of Chakhama Ukrul, and self-styled Sergeant Rain Singh, age 20, son of Yevung, resident of Kalhang Ukrul. A civil guide for underground cadres, namely Tongja Thang, age 30, son of Zhang Khumang, resident of Thingpil, Myanmar, was also apprehended by the troops. One AK-56 series assault rifle, along with two magazines, one AK-81 5.56mm, along with two magazines, one HK-33 assault rifle 5.56mm, along with two magazines, 120 numbers of 5.56mm ammunition, 60 number of 7.62mm ammunition, one Chinese hand grenade and another incriminating articles were recovered from the possession. The arrested persons along with recovered items have been handed over to Kachin Police Station. A driver of 7 Assam Rifles in Churachampur died after his Mini Tata met with an accident yesterday. The driver has been identified as Havildar Harding Panda, age 46, son of Mahindra of Sumagar village, Uttarakhand. He was rushed to Sijo Hospital where he succumbed to his injuries. Now some sports news. In the second Lamlai Kendra Village Wise Men's Open 7A-side football tournament, league match between NSA Nongdam and SPYC Saijang ended in a draw, while YDCL Pungdombom won its respective match. In the second league match played at Lamlai Students Idol Club, Lamlai Football Ground, NSA Nongdam and SPYC Saijang scored one goal each in the given time to draw the match. In the third league match, YDCL Pungdombom defeated CHYUC Chalo by 4-2. YDCL Pungdombom player Telhaiba scored two goals, while Binod and Mochabi scored one goal each. The two goals for CHYUC Chalo were scored by Maingo and Manisana. The tournament organized by FC Lamlai kicked off yesterday. 18 teams are participating in the tournament. Today, Langol Tarung Foundation Day and Cultural Festival kicked off today. Thangmaiban MLA assured the locals of Tarung village of portable water supply for villages from any available source, even if government fails to do so. Speaking on the occasion, MLA Joy Kishan said he had drawn the attention of the minister concerned in the assembly over the non-availability of portable water supply in Tarung village and even offered to provide water pipe from his capacity for the scheme. MLA Joy Kishan also wished that the festival may set as an example of brotherhood and unity among hills and valley and various communities living in the state. Vice Chairperson of IMC, Chairman Tarung Village, amongst other, attended the event.
Akoina pipe su putoksarage haraga ising pibanga moi haibagi madugi phiyam do laigrabani na karamba source tagi taroga pib yagada ge du means ai athubu da putoksarage lairiba government se taudra su ai angamba tharga tarung bilkul gi village da ai ngasi ai pijari tarung kul gi narol satra satri youth sing se masi masamo phana leiba tungi oiba yumbure loi oigeda ngatani na nisa dagi lapthokna lainaba adu kamai taroga khoi lairib sing si healthy way na ba mong da tau kare hai ba si koi sanction ji.
The third Peace and Harmony Summer Badminton Cash Prize Men's Open Badminton Tournament, which began on the 9th of April in Moray, concluded today. The closing ceremony of the tournament was held at the Indo-Myanmar Border Badminton Association's Indoor Hall in Moray, Ward No. 4. Sasang and Luvlan emerged as the champions of the doubles final match played today. Moray ADC, additional SP along with badminton enthusiasts attended the closing ceremony. First Chepu Trophy kicked off today at Chepu Yaulan Village Public Ground in Ukrul with 17 teams participating in the meet. Ukhrul District Deputy Commissioner Rishikesh Modak inaugurated football tournament today. Deputy Commissioner Modak said the tournament will help the youths to stay healthy. He said the sports meet is an opportunity to groom young talents who can represent in national and international level. The second International Students Game 2015-2016 will be held from 26th of April till the 30th of April at Thimphu, Bhutan. The list of players and officials who will represent Manipur in the under-19 football team has been announced. Northeast Students Olympic Association in a press release informs that the team will leave for Thimphu on the 23rd of April. With that, it's a wrap in this edition of Primetime English News. Before we end, a look at the headlines once again. Chief Minister welcomes Sri Sri Ravi Shankar to take part in peace talks if insurgent groups come forward for dialogue with the government. Locals of Wanghai Hijam Rairak boycott Wanghai Panthau and his followers over land issue. Imalai Sem Inat Loisang denies allegation. And All Manipur Entrepreneurs Association identifies new business opportunities between India and Myanmar during 12-day tour to neighbouring countries.